people.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
The other one, the second owner, he tells them, I don't want to do a sloppy job. I don't want to sell this vehicle half fixed. I don't want to sell this vehicle to a person where they're going to have to tear it all apart and then redo it again. So without, he usually just jumps into it. He don't even tell the owner, his first owner, because he's second in charge, right? He tells them, he's all like, well, he don't even tell them. He just tells the other workers, this is what we're going to do. We're going to strip this car down to the frame, sandblast it, paint it, put new axles on there, put new brake lines, put new everything, brand new.
Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
You see, that's what the Lord wants us to do. We don't want, He don't want us to rush into things that we're going to get hurt. We're going to trip and fall. We're going to get lost. Then we're going to start pointing fingers. Then that's when we walk away from God. But God don't want that. It's just like regular parents. Amen? Human parents today. Our kids, huh? They want to rush into things. Amen? I can say that now because I have two. Amen? Before, I didn't understand. My dad always used to say, wait till you have kids. Wait till you have a son. You don't understand what I'm going through. Amen? And my son is a handful. He's here today. He'll be knocking this plant over. He'll be over here. Actually, he'll be over here at the drum. Amen? Second place he'll go to is the guitar. Third place he'll go to is pick up one of these mics. Amen? You gotta be patient with them, huh?
Jesus.
You see, but God wants us to be patient with Him. He wants us to trust Him.
Jesus.
He wants us to have hope in Him. So that He can give us power. Build our power.
Jesus.
Amen. It's just like these cell phones. When we get cell phones on, you automatically just want to rush in there and put all your contacts in there. Get the
Jesus.
Facebook app on there, and then whatever else the apps are on there. I don't even know anymore.
YouTube.
Man, when I first got my phone, you know what the first app I put on it? The Bible. Amen.
Jesus.
And to this day, I use it. I have Navajo Bible and all different kind of types of translation and Bible on it. And it helps. Amen. But anyways, God, He wants us to wait upon Him. Amen.
Jesus, yes.
So that He can fix us in the way He wants to fix us. Amen. See, like that guy was telling you, the first owner, he wanted just to fix the outside of the vehicle, paint it real nice, maybe fix the interior a little bit, and then make the motor sound nice and then sell it. What if the frame was cracked? What if the axle wasn't running? What if the motor was actually really not good? But the other owner, he looks at every single one of them very carefully. He listens to it, and he even takes it apart and he puts it back together.
Jesus.
God wants to do it to us. Wherever we're hurt. Amen.
Jesus.
Wherever we're hurt. Wherever we're lacking. He's a resource there.
Jesus.
Adjust your carburetor. He's going to line your wheels. You might be rubbing your tires on the inside or the outside or in the middle. You might be turning to the right or turning to the left. Amen.
Jesus.
God wants to fix you. And there's no other place. Just think about if you're a vehicle.
Jesus.
Would you go to a Giant's gas station and say, I need an oil change?
Jesus.
Yep. Amen. Archie went on and said, yep.
Nope.
Amen.
I said, nope.
Oh. Uh-huh. Amen. Uh-huh. No, they're a vehicle. You take it to your shop, huh?
Yep.
See, the exact same way with us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God created us. He's our source. There's nothing that will equal to Him.
Jesus, yeah, Jesus.
He's everlasting.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's without beginning and without end. He lasts forever. Amen. He may update your phone, get the today's phone that just came out. And another 2 months later, another one will be coming out and you're going to be wanting that one again. Amen. But God don't, but He don't change.
Jesus.
Amen. He don't change at all. He's going to love you no matter what.
Amen.
He's going to love you no matter what. So He's saying right here, look up. Lift your eyes. Lift up your eyes on high. Verse 26. And behold, who had created these things that bring us out by hosts, by numbers, and call them by all the names. Amen. Now this is where it kind of gets. Amen. Like I was saying, if you rush into things, like with me, when I was in high school, my auntie was selling a car. It was a 78 Cutlass Supreme. Man, the outside looked nice. The interior was green, my favorite color. You know, and exhaust pipes sticking out in the back. Had some fat tires on, rims on there. Looked like a little kind of shishy. Amen?
My.
But yet, I wanted that car.
Jesus.
Amen? My parents kept asking, you sure? Are you sure? Just wait. Especially my mom. Just wait. No, I want that car. Please. Can you get it for me, please? Hey, mom. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
So they got it. This is sad. Just maybe just to shut me up. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And made me learn from that. They got me that car. It ran me about 6 months. The motor started knocking. I got a motor for it. Put it back in. There, it kind of did a little adjustment to it. Took it into school, autos, and I had autos, and I did some adjustments to it. Amen.
Yeah.
And a naughty kid that I was, I started racing my fellow classmates. Amen. Then I rushed into that car. Next thing you know, people started hating me for that car. Left that in the highway, and because our road used to get muddy, and that car had street tires on there, and you know, cars, they won't go good in the mud, huh? Left it at the highway, and someone put sugar in the gas tank. Ruined that car. Amen. My mom and dad were upset, and my mom told me, if you just waited, I would have got you a Mustang, she said. Amen. And I was just like, what? You should have told me I would have got the car instead. She said, I want you to wait. Amen. She was, now think about it, in the Lord's time, wait upon the Lord. Then we rush into the No, Lord, I want to do it this way. Go ahead, see what happens. Just remember, he's gonna let you go. Amen. He's gonna let you do it. But he's gonna keep you, just like how this microphone is attached to this cord. He's not gonna leave you like this one. He's not just gonna let you go. If I threw this one, it's just gonna land over there. Amen. But this one, if I throw, I'm not gonna do it.
I throw it. He still got the hold of you.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. He said, I still got a hold of you. Just think about it. I seen some parents in Walmart one time. Little kids running around, they're like, sit still. Get over here, sit still. And they have like, remember the racks in there, the shelves? He started climbing on it. Lucky it was the toilet paper section. He started climbing on there, and all those toilet papers fell on that little boy. He started crying. The parents all, see what you get? Amen? I have any father, don't say that, so that's not.
No, amen.
He'll dust us off and say that. Wait. Let me show you. Let me teach you. Let me build up your power so you can accomplish. So you can have the ability to do, to act, to accomplish something. Amen?
Jesus.
But yet, we want to do things our own way. This is what happens when you look. Verse 27. It says, Israel, the Navajos, Kachinis, Kiamanis. Any other tribe in here? Any other clan in here? Totsani, Tenabithni. For the genies.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. He's saying right here, Israel, my people, why then do you complain? Amen. Why then do you complain? I'm telling you, I have this power that I'm giving to you. I'm telling you, I create all these stars and hills, mountains, waters, lands, birds, fish. I created all things. I created you. But why are you complaining? That the Lord doesn't know your trouble? Amen? The Lord knows our trouble.
Yes.
That the Lord doesn't know your trouble or cares if you suffer injustice.
Jesus.
Amen?
Mm-hmm.
You know, one thing I notice about being a Christian, we're always going to have trials, tribulation, aches and pain. Amen? It's just like, we got to take care of our bodies, huh? Amen? One thing I notice too is, you know, I used to hear this a lot from a lot of older Christians. The Lord says, I can pray for this soda pop and it'll be good for me. In the name of Jesus, this soda can, this soda pop, this Coca-Cola, Pepsi, Dr. Pepper. It's not going to give me sugar diabetes. Amen? And Jesus was talking about right here, he's saying, the temple. It's going to be torn down.
Yeah,
yes. Amen? And later on, he was saying that your body has been bought with a price.
Amen?
Amen? Amen. But we need to take care of his body. Because you're the temple of the Lord, huh?
Amen. Amen.
I tell some of my congregation, you need to take care of yourself. Watch out what you say. Watch how you act.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right.
There's this Jesus. One song that goes, oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. For the Father up above is looking down in love. Be careful, little hands, what you do. Talks about your eyes. Talks about your mouth. Talks about your ears. Talks about your feet. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And that's all. And I was telling the congregation, because during the week, I see them, they come to me and they say, oh, I got a new tattoo. What did the Word tell us this past Sunday? Your body is the temple of the Lord.
Yes.
Yes.
When you're giving yourself tattoos, you're giving yourself a bad picture for the Lord.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Yes.
And here we start complaining. He told me one time, it's in the Bible. Jesus had a tattoo on his leg inside his leg.
Oh man.
Are you sure it was a tattoo? Maybe it was a brand, is it that thing?
Mm-hmm.
His body was so mangled. His body was so torn up. How can his skin hold
Jesus.
Blood or eat?
Jesus.
So they probably brained him, huh?
Jesus.
Now, I'm not saying go and put bar in on your arm here. Amen? Or your cow symbol, I don't know. K lazy Z Y or something. Amen?
Amen.
You know? And we start complaining, huh? We start doing things on our own, wanting to look cool, wanting to fit in. Mm-hmm. Our mind just takes off. Oh, this money for the camp meeting. Oh, man, it's getting on my nerves. I'm going to go collect cans. Maybe I'll sell my sheep. Oh, I know, I'm going to go cut some firewood and sell it. I'm a fast weaver. I'm going to weave real fast and make sesame. Amen? We try to do it, huh? And then we end up not getting as much. Then we complain. Amen? But God says right here, says, I know your troubles. I know your cares. I know how much you're suffering. Verse 28 says, don't you know? Amen? Don't you know? Haven't you heard?